Hey, what is up, everyone? All right, I had promised I was gonna do these. I decided there's no time like the present. So this is a brand new series I'm gonna do on YouTube called Open That Book, Rich. Okay, so if you followed my channel a little bit, I've made reference to this at least a couple of times, but I have a lot of books that I really never looked at. In my defense, I'm very driven with my own personal work. I've talked about like even things like watching a movie, listening to other people's music. It's like it all just makes me want to work on my own stuff. And so if I had an opportunity to look at someone's art book or sit and draw, I'll sit and draw 100 times out of 103 before I'll look at something else. It's just the way that I'm wired. I've been like this since I was a little kid. I'd almost equate it to like an ADD. I can never remember what it's called. But anyway, but yeah, so I have all these books that I've bought. I have flipped through this, but maybe only one time, twice at the most. I'm not even sure. I bought KABA 2 first. I got this probably like 3 years ago. As you can see, it's like still sealed. I have no idea what's in it. Like I couldn't even tell you. There's only one piece from the two books that even I can recall from looking at them, which is he did this really great drawing of like cyclists going up like a hill. So we'll see if it's in here. But yeah, so this is gonna be really fun. Brand new series of things. I have so many books that we can go through together, and hopefully this will actually inspire me to not only draw more, but it'll give me ideas. It'll be an opportunity for you to see books, see artists maybe that you don't know or you're a fan of, but you've never seen the book. I'm pretty sure that KABA 1, this book is pretty rare. I think it's rare. Who knows? They always reprint stuff, but here, let's pop it open. Still in the shrink, yo. My daughter would watch like freaking Shopkins unboxing videos. The lady would get like a million views in a freaking day. I'm not even kidding. So I know we're never gonna get there with this channel, but that's not even the point. I'm just saying that like it's a whole experience. It's the sound of the wrapper. It's the beauty of the book. All right, so yeah, Otomo. Not even exaggerating when I say this, he's one of my favorite artists of all time. Easily top 10. At times I would put him in like my top three. I'd say like Travis, Mobius, and Otomo. They're up there. And then if we get into fine art, it gets sketchy because there's fine arts that I like that really sort of like raise the bar. Okay, so what do we got here? We've got like a one sheet. This is like a record album. The Japanese do not mess around. Their packaging is absolutely stunning. They always bring it. You always want to keep your OB strip on stuff. This book didn't come with one, but never throw away an OB strip. It's word to the wise. Okay, so I have to be careful. I've like still got some art supplies out, so let's see. So yeah, so this is like a loose, I don't even know what this is exactly, but anyway. Okay, so let's do this. I'm gonna set this over here. Right, textured paper here. It's very actually nice. It sucked because this one of the two books, and I think it was this one, came sort of like with like a little bit of factory flaw. I was a little pissed off at that because usually that'd be the other thing is people that sell in Japan, they're super anal about like the quality, and they're very very good at like disclosing like any sort of flaws and whatnot. You can see I put a towel down because although I did clean my desk, there's some like ink and stuff like that I just don't want to make sure that. That's kind of weird. What was that? It's like, oh, someone must be bringing their trash cans. I was like trying to figure out what that noise is outside. It's trash day in my neighborhood. So we'll just flip through. I'm kind of more focused on just like the images than like this, whatever the story behind the book. I mean, it's a collection of his works from 1971 to 1989. And definitely doesn't cover everything. So, but yeah, like, I mean, Otomo is so great because it's just like, he's such a good artist. There's, it's beautiful line work. He's great at color. The storytelling in the drawings is just unbelievable. I mean, there's no downside really to Otomo's stuff. It's just beautiful, beautiful, beautiful work. He's so creative. He's got that Mobius kind of vibe to his stuff. I'll kind of scoot the book. Like, it's funky because if I pull it up, then we're getting like, I don't know if it'll, let me see if I can get this to stay up here. Sorry, this is a little bit of a work in progress. I want to go with this though and just get these going. So we'll fine tune it. I can always come back to this book. And again, I have KABA too. So regardless, we're going to do another Otomo book. I've also got Akira Club, which is a great book. But okay, so that'll work. But I mean, check this stuff out. I mean, his sense of space, negative space, meaning like where he doesn't draw, is so powerful. It's so good. Otomo is the fucking man. He inspires me to curse. Look at that. Come on. Who does that? Okay, the only thing that I'm going to say, though, is I am under the impression that he does sometimes use assistants for backgrounds. I would guess on a piece like this, he didn't. It's not a very detailed background. But I think when he worked on Akira, and someone correct me if I'm incorrect on that, but I think when he was doing the series Akira, that there were assistants that he would use for backgrounds. But at the end of the day, he's art directing it, and it's phenomenal stuff. God damn. Shit is good. Like I said, there's a reason this guy is like one of my favorite artists of all times. Top three. That's a big, big... That's a bold statement from me, because I'm telling you, as you saw in the last video, look at the I don't know if you can see this. Look at the reflection in this guy's helmet. There's trouble coming. There's more shit. His buddy's already been like all fucked up. These dudes, there's more coming in his helmet. This is Otomo. It's the storytelling. It's everything. The guy is so good. Look at this. Beautiful, beautiful work. You have to get this book. I want to say that it cost me somewhere between 80 and 110 bucks when I bought it. I could be wrong, but I think that was like in that realm. But, you know, don't, well, it's weird. Because you just never know if they're going to reprint this stuff. This is the first printing of the book. Blah, 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 big deal. Guy's got a Telecaster, very cool. Fender, baby. Hopefully this is fun to check out. Like, I hope you're already, like digging this new series. I haven't really seen too many people doing this type of thing in terms of, like, comic book artists going through books that they own that they've never really looked at. So it's like, kind of like a first look. Man, I love the foliage that he drew there. So nice. God damn. He's so good. He's so, so talented. Oh, that's really cool. It's kind of like Dada art, a little. I'll kind of sort of slide it down, but there's a little bit of photo, like the moon is like a photo stat. Very cool, though. I love stuff like this, though. I like very sort of whimsical, I don't know what you'd call it. Just, it's like kind of like that Monty Python art. That's nice. Oh, wow. So here's like the black and white, like, layout of that illustration. Oh, gosh. So cool. Sorry, I'm trying to adjust the phone. So I'm, like... But, yeah, just, like, here, we'll zoom in a little bit on this. Look at that. Isn't that nice? Look at the snake's head. The lighting on it, like, the little white spots. Just killer. The eye socket, too, is actually very cool. Like, he just, it's like very, very well done. It would be hard for me. I'd have to kind of break it down. We'll do that in other videos down the road, like sort of the nuts and bolts of form. The pig guy is great. Oh man, this looks great on my camera. I hope it really like kind of reads well on the YouTube. Wow, this book is thick. Okay, we're gonna start moving. Sorry. This almost has a little bit of like a Juan Jimenez feel, which doesn't surprise me, only because if you think about the time period that this stuff was done, the early 70s, you know, sci-fi was just really blowing up. Heavy metal, metal Erlon, and all that were very, very big. Mobius, some of the Akira stuff. Sorry for the glare. It's going to be impossible for me to really, like, light these pages without having some kind of glare, but I'm trying to do my best with this. Akira is fantastic. I have the black and white phone books, and then I have probably, I think it went to 100 issues in comic form. I probably have like 80 of the 100, and those will be the color versions of it. But yeah, here's some more of the pretty famous cover from the book. Okay, let's see here. Yeah, so I'm thinking Kaba too might have that bike. I love this piece. Great drapery here. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm kind of trying to adjust the phone and get decent shots. Sorry, my hands are dirty. I've been working all day. But yeah, so I think like stuff like this, he may have used assistance for. Not 100% sure. The backgrounds in Akira get very, very... sorry, I'm going to try to pull this out a little bit so that we can get more of the full page view. But yeah, there's a lot of backgrounds in Akira, and it wouldn't surprise me if he did use assistance for some of it. Again, very, very Mobius. The colors feel very kind of Mobius inspired. This is really nice. Wow. Oh, I have so many good books to share with you all. You guys are going to be stoked. Okay, we'll kind of scoot through these a little quicker. Pretty simple. It's nice. Oh, and the bubble popped. It's actually pretty cool. So you got this and that. I actually really like the way that he did the breaking of the bubble. You know, never gloss over like little things like that, because the shapes and form and stuff that they're creating are really, really important and kind of like clues to bigger drawing problems that you'd actually face. I have no clue what this stuff is for. I honestly, like, none of this stuff looks familiar to me, so I don't even remember looking through this book. Comics. Okay, let's see. Oh, wow. Man, that's awesome. Kind of an M.C. Escher kind of vibe on that. Oh, this might be Memories. Oh, Fireball. Very cool, very cool. Oh, I love this and Akira, the sort of like slanted tech tunnels. I don't know what they would be called. Sorry if I'm like totally boneheading like sort of descriptions up. Like, again, it's probably not my strongest suit. I'm more visual. And then like whatever I come up with, man, that's a really nice face. Rendered to shit too. Man, there's so much detail. You want to be careful with stuff like this early on, though. If you don't really understand value and also, like, sort of, like, form and shading, you're just going to basically, like, spend a lot of time on drawings for kind of no reason. It's not to dissuade people from trying it, but, you know what I mean? Like, kind of go into it knowing that, like, you should only really probably do a few if you're going to spend massive amounts of time. Either use some photo reference so that you understand, like, the lighting that you're trying to, like, sort of, like, recreate, or, work up to it, you know. Use some Copic markers until you get like the values and stuff sort of pop in, and then you can go in and sorry, my hands are all busted up too on top of it. It's like super dry here, so like my hands are cracked, and like it's like I've been working like for 50 days straight, so you can only imagine the wear and tear that that puts on your body. It's a nice little panel right there. That castle. Oh, so good. Man, it's just crazy. Those look very Vegas-y. The hotel there. Yeah, stuff is so nice. That really famous photo from Vietnam. What do you think? Is this cool? Are you guys digging this? I hope so. This is fun for me, and it's really cool to see this book. It's, like, exciting, because, again, he's one of my favorite artists. I just never really had the appropriate time to sit down and enjoy the book, and that's kind of what it's about, is being able to spend some quality time with it, you know? When you work 60 to 80 hours a week, I mean, your free time is so limited, and when I'm done, I mean, I do kind of need to recharge for the next day, so sometimes, like, looking at art and stuff like that is not the best way to do it. So, it's really interesting. Wow. Some crazy ideas and some commercials. Try not to skip pages, but at the same time, we do got to kind of move. Wow, that's really cool. Oh, and it's, yeah, this Bruegel. Bruegel is great. Like this, I think it's pronounced Peter Bruegel. But yeah, I love that. That actual painting is really, really cool. It's interesting, like, how the influence, sorry, I'm trying to zoom to 1%. There we go. Yeah, I mean, fine art is sort of like the gateway to it all. It can take a little getting used to if you don't like it. Give it a chance, go back and check it out again and again, because it can be a bit of an acquired taste. It's like it's just a really heavy foundation for everything. Color theory, and, you know, you're really seeing the kind of core of art developing. It's very, very enriching. Wow, that's really cool. To get into, so it's definitely worth the time. Wow, because this is interesting. So, yeah, I would say that I looked at this book very, very little. If I look through it one time, it's probably a miracle, because I don't remember any of this stuff. KABA 2, I think I flipped through 2 or 3 times, and then this book maybe just once when I got it. But yeah, I don't remember any of this stuff. It's very cool. Okay, so we're getting to the end of this. I wanted to kind of keep these videos somewhat short. This is 18 minutes, so it went way longer than I wanted, because I wanted to have videos that you could watch and not have to eat up a bunch of time. But anyway, so that is... Oh, hold on. Oh, man, there's like a big chunk of book left. I thought this was the end. Okay, so... this I haven't seen. Weapons. This is really interesting. And this is the thing, is when people get very, very precious about, like, a few drawings that they've done, and they're at the very front end of their career, I mean, look at the body of work that this guy created. And then you start to realize that the skill level that these guys have is based on, you know, time working on art and just thousands and thousands of drawings. You know, that's what it's about. It's about creating art, creating a consistent, you know, sort of work pattern, and you're just going to get better and better at what you do. And it's kind of almost as like an Arthur Sydam view, like, look. But yeah, I mean, it's really, really kind of key to building up your repertoire. And I don't think Otomo has tattoos, though. That might not be his arm. I could be wrong, but I kind of don't think that's his arm. Hey, look. Crow quills. What? Okay, well, we're at the end of the book. I hope this was fun to check out. I mean, this is the first one of these, so, you know, please be patient as I sort of build up sort of, like, not only an approach to it, but you know, a way to deliver interesting sort of verbal information along with it. Hey, and look, some album cover art. These might be influences of his, which is interesting because I see some stuff that inspires me in there. But yeah, you know, this will grow like anything, and I can always come and revisit any books that didn't sort of like get their just due. But yeah, so this is KABA 1 by Otomo Katsuhiro, and really cool. I think the KABA 2 book is going to really like knock you on your ass more, though. But this is a good start. So yeah, open that book, Rich. Otomo KABA. All right, thanks for tuning in. I will talk to you later, and hopefully you enjoyed this. Bye.